Hi, iUniversity Prep. Today we're going to talk about physical versus chemical changes. Let's start with physical change. A physical change is a change that takes place, doesn't change the inherent properties of that substance. It's still the same chemical. For example, we have some household aluminum foil. If I rip this foil in half, it is still just aluminum foil. If you zoomed in with the microscope, the atoms, the molecules are still aluminum foil. We have not changed that. So that's just a physical change. If we change the size, the shape, the volume, I crumple this up, I have not changed the molecules of the foil. It is still just aluminum foil. Whatever molecules make up aluminum foil, which most of it's just aluminum, it's still just that. If I bend it some more, I break it, I twist it, I turn it, those are all just physical changes. So let's talk about chemical changes. What is a chemical change? A chemical change is when you get a new substance that cannot easily be undone. For example, if you baked a cake, if you took eggs, flour, sugar, whatever else you want to put in it, and you heat it up and you bake a cake, you can't easily undo that. You can't take that cake and turn it back into eggs, flour, and sugar. That is a new substance. And there's a lot of other chemical reactions out there. And a way to remember if a chemical reaction has taken place is city guys love their cell phones. Let's start with C for city. That stands for corrosion or rust. Take iron, for example, or if you leave your bicycle out in the rain for a year, after a while, it will rust. This orange-red material forms. That's a new substance. That's iron combining with oxygen in the air, rearranging, and you have a new product, a new substance. It is no longer just iron and just oxygen. So that's a chemical reaction. G stands for gas or bubbles. So if you mix two chemicals together and you produce gas and bubbles, you're pretty positive that a chemical reaction has taken place. Now let's talk about L, love. If light is produced, if light is produced by mixing two chemicals together, you better believe it's a chemical reaction. In order for light to be produced, that doesn't come from nowhere. It has to come from somewhere, electrons rearranging, releasing a lot of energy to the point where light is produced. So if you see light produced, you know it's a chemical reaction. T stands for temperature change. If you mix two chemicals together and heat is produced, or if it gets cold, an endothermic reaction, you better believe a chemical reaction took place. Now, the exception is if you take a pot and put it on a hot stove and the pot gets hot, that's not a chemical reaction because we didn't get a new substance. Remember, overall, you have to have a new substance for a chemical reaction to take place. All right, so let's go to that next C. That stands for color change. Pick anything that has a color. The reason it has a color is because that's the molecules reflecting that light. So if you change the color of a substance, you are changing the molecules. P for precipitate. So precipitate's a little less common. You don't really see that every day. So what is a precipitate? A precipitate is when you mix two liquids together and you get a solid. And that doesn't happen often. If you mix water and milk together, it doesn't just magically form a solid. So we're going to look at an example where mixing two liquids together makes a solid.
All right, so we talked about evidence of a chemical change. One of the main ones is a precipitate forming, when two liquids form a solid. So we have a great example of that, and another evidence happens. See if you can catch that. So right here we have sodium hydroxide solution, and we have a lead nitrate solution. Now, don't blink, here we go. So, two chemical reaction evidences just took place. We have a color change and a precipitate. Now remember, I said two liquids making a solid, and if I go in here, we actually have little solid chunks now. We went from two liquids to a solid, and definitely a color change, as you can see.